It's 59 already, 11:59. So welcome to a new week at Elizabeth Craft Designs. I'm going to, I have all kind of plans in my head, but most I want to show you to stretch your time to travel collection, because I know we got questions about when is the next Sidekick collection is coming. Esther is working on that, but I'm going to show you that with the time to travel, if you have both, because I know a lot of people have planners and sidekicks, that you can do a lot with this collection in your sidekick as well. I tried some card shapes as well, so I'm going to show you that. And I make something, so I prepped something. I had loads of fun at Create & Craft, I have to say, this weekend. Let me find myself first. And that was fun.
59 already.
Oh, wait, sound on. Oops, there we go. And it was loads of fun. And during the program, we had lots of ideas coming, kind of floating around. So that's always fun, getting inspired. And before I forget to say, the winner of the $50 gift certificate is Karen Hayes Frank. Karen Hayes Frank. Karen, congratulations. If you email info@craftdesigns.com, Angel will help you on. So, other than that, it's gorgeous weather here. And tomorrow is my birthday. I need to see if we can do something with that. But I actually take a day off tomorrow. We're going to the new house, check some things out, and have lunch. And, you know, so maybe I'll take a day off tomorrow. That could happen. Okay, so let's turn the camera around and let's get started. So we can go there. Hello, everyone. So hello, Belinda, Rhonda, Christine. Hi, everybody. And I miss a lot of people already. So like, comment and share, of course, to make a chance for the new $50 gift certificate. How come I never win? Michelle, if I see your name, I said, no, not her. No, that's not true. Yeah. I know, Sue, I see it always passing by. I know you share as well. Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you. Yeah. 61 tomorrow. Serious, getting serious here. Okay, so what I want to do first, I want to go through the through my samples quickly, because I know Esther showed you something, but she didn't have her own samples because I had those. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I know. It's a day off. Yeah. So these are the ones from Karen. So I'm going to show you those in a second. And so basically, and I did that yesterday with Create & Craft as well, but because it's nice to see the possibilities. But I know Esther showed you all the possibilities on Friday with the different dies, but she didn't have these samples. So I want to go through these. And then, hi from Germany. Hi, Susa. And Antje also from Germany. But so I want to show you the samples that Esther had the pieces from. So you see, so that's the one with the three portholes. And I had loads of fun kind of trying and working with these. You see, so that's this page. That's this one. Then this one is the one with the rope here. So that's this page. Then you have this part here. And you can use most of it for, honestly, for the sidekick as well. And I'm going to show you that. So this one with the holiday house, like this one. And then we said, oh, a beach shack. Like it's a beach shack. It can be a garden shack. It can be anything. So that's something I want to do as well. Like show and tell a little bit. So many possibilities. Then this one, I absolutely love this one. I made two now. Like that a lot. So that one. That's that. And then, of course, combined with the first page I showed you. Then this one, the shutter, which combines with... I made one of those. I'm going to show you that. So that is the die. Oh, that's coming in a second. So this one, that's, of course, the Irish shutter. And then... I see a piece is loose here. Here we go. And that's the Irish shutter. And then all those things that you can use on a slimline card as well. So I'm going to show you that. Thank you, everybody, for the birthday wishes. Thank you. And then here you see those parts as well. You see that one. And let me show you the card, because I took a card from Karen Gerber apart. I think she's at sea at the moment, so she's probably not seeing this. But I took a card from her apart. It kind of matched the paper from this, the book two here. And I used that element, because that will be so beautiful with the florals as well. So I used the paper and then put some elements from the new collection there. You see? So that's just a great way to use in different ways as well. And then, and here I have the samples from David. I know he showed them already online. So here you see the three portholes again. Here he used paper from Graphic 45, like there's lots going on here, like the, there you see the octopus overlay. Here you see the octopus like in silver. Lots and lots of things going on there. Here's more tropical. So if you use that in the lime, the orange, and the, it can be a grapefruit, can be anything, of course, that has a little bit of shape. But then also, this can also be an old wheelbarrow, which is great, I think. And then here, this is the one. Oh, this one actually Esther showed as well, because David made two of those, I know. Well, and the samples I want to show you as well are the samples from Karen Gerber. And I know I think she's at sea, because I think she's on a cruise. Your label in there, of course, you can put pens in there, you can put anything in there. And oh, that's, yeah, I was, so Joep lost his glasses. Joep doesn't know where his glasses are. And then I said, oh, I saw something, glasses in a weird place. So, and I always think where did he left them. But now I remember, I saw a picture that Esther did that or something. Somebody put glasses in here. So those were not Joep's glasses. So he needs to look somewhere else then. You see, so this from Karen, this was actually on a cruise. I think this was a teaching cruise for her. Could be. So that's a shaker, the summer here, that octopus. She puts breads through it. I use the bolts and nuts from the die. Love that, you see. So I think this was a teaching cruise. I know she does that. And I think Annette Green is going on a cruise as well at one point, a teaching cruise. So that happens here a lot for the people in Europe. So if you want to do a cruise, a craft cruise, they're going on here. Did she that, Belinda? Did she do that? You know, and I was saying to you this morning, I said, I saw glasses put in a weird place that I thought, who puts glasses there? So it was Janice. I did not know that anymore. So we need to find Joep's glasses then. You see, and what Karen did, she put the pockets in there as well, which I love, she says, because then you can kind of put some more pictures in there, of course. And yeah, time change. Oh yeah, about the time change, that's correct. Oh, I should have posted that. Yeah, we change time. Yeah, we change time. And here you see elements from the die sets. Here you see the page with all the fruit. And then here the chair and you know, just fun elements. This one is, this opens. You see, so there's a magnet here and there's a magnet here. So this opens and closes like this. See, so that's a great one. And here you see the another page, like a pocket page. Here she has the one with the rope. And you can attach that to a base page if you want to, but you don't need to. Yeah, Tracy, the pages are great. It's, you know, and it's fun. So it's kind of fun to document your trip like that. Here and on the back she has the same. And then the life is good. That's from one of the... one of the dies here, more pictures. I like how she kind of wove in those pockets. Hi Jona, yeah, we are we changed time, but you didn't yet, and I forgot to mention that. But we moved an hour forward. So is it now 7 in the Netherlands and 6 in the UK? I think that is. Is it 7 in the Netherlands now? Pretty sure it is. Yeah, yeah. And this one she glued together. So this is the shutter, but then she glued it together, you see. So that's kind of more a decorative way. And then here, this is, I like this as well. So here she has like a magnet here, and then this opens up, you see. So it goes like this. So that's actually a nice beach there. Goes like this and that. And then you see, here you see those frames as well. So these are the ones from Karen Gerber. So, and is she here? Yeah. Okay, it's 7. Yeah. And 6 in the UK. That's what I thought. Yeah. I forgot to give that. Well, we talked about it last week, but I didn't really talk about it during kind of announcement. Okay, so what I want to do, I want to go through the sets. And then, let me see. I'm going to start with the rope one. And then I'm going to show you what I did with that already. So I only cut pieces because yesterday I was up really early and, you know, I was in the studio for a long time, so I thought, okay, I'm going to go home, everything is here, and I am going to enjoy the rest of the day. But I have lots to show and tell. So I kind of what I'm going to show you, I did this morning. So this is the Sidekick. So first of all, of course, you have the shutter here. I will show you in a second that those frames fit as well. So these are the smaller pages. So what I did with this one, I'm actually going to get my all my stuff here. And I did not get the book yet. So I actually have copies here, which is shiny and not as nice. But it gives you the idea. Okay, so what I did, let me show you this one. So this is now a page for the Sidekick. See, here you go. Isn't that perfect? That is as perfect as it gets. So what you do with the dies, you kind of figure out what works the best, what works the best where. So I'm going to show you what I did with this one. So I let me see, I do have magnetic closures, never used. Yeah, I have those little magnets. Yeah, I have those little magnets. So what I did is I took the base page from the Sidekick. So that's this one. So I just die cut the page. Of course, there are pages with tabs as well. But I thought for this one, this is absolutely the best to use. So I did die cut this page, you see. And then you have the blank page. Then I took this one. And I figured out where the best place was to put this. And I think in this case, it's, oh, here. You see, so if you, because if I put it at the top or the bottom, depending on how you hold it, you see, and then you, the only thing you need to make sure that you line, but you get a grip here. So if you line your page up, you will not, you don't want to go over that cut edge here. So you basically, when you put your page down, I kind of figured out, oh, this will be a good match. Then you slide it on there and you go over a little bit. So what I do is I kind of line it up and then it grips on the bottom here. So make sure that you don't cut over this one. You see, and then you look on the back because there's a cutting edge as well. So that looks great. And then I run it through. So now you have a fantastic page for your Sidekick, which I thought was really cool. I'm going to put it in here. Well, I'm going to put, because I know I have a blank page. Where's my, I saw a blue one in here. Was it in here? Yeah, let me put it here. I can put it here as well, of course, depending on. You see how cool that is? Here you go. Cannot be any more perfect. So there you have your Sidekick page. Then I also did an A4 size card. So 5.5 by 4.25. And I made an, this piece is 4 by 5.25. And then again, I looked at where my, and I think in this case, it was in the middle somewhere. Let me see. At the bottom. You see, almost at the bottom. So I kind of looked and I thought, oh, if you look here, you kind of can see, okay, this kind of, it ends in the middle of a rope and it's, and here as well. So it's not even at the bottom. You see, it's not all the way at the bottom. But you see, I just lined that up on the edge of the card, on the piece, and run it through. And now you have an A2 size card. So I did that one. And then, of course, think about, well, you can put anything on there. But here, if you look at that, and in a different color, then you have a great card. So many possibilities, so many possibilities. So that is the A2 size card. So that's with the rope. Then I had this piece, and I think, how will that work on a page? Let me get this page out. This is actually from the, you see, from the back of that one. So this one, I can easily, and what I could, can I do that? Let me see. I just want, because I would like to see that stitching there as well. I think if I make a mark, I didn't do that yet. Okay, let's see. Because you see, if you trim it here, but I would like to have that stitch mark there. So in that case, I would go about here. So I want to go about there. Let's see if I, because then I need to use, I can use this side here at the bottom, because that stitch, will that work? I think that will work. So let me line this up here. And again, you feel the grip. You feel the grip of the sides here. So if I put this about here, then I'm going to tape it down. Tape, tape, tape. I do have tape. And then I'm going to run it through my machine, and I'm going to run it through. I'm going in this side because I don't want this to go all the way in. I just want to go this piece in. And of course you hear it cut and then you're done basically. So glue this down. I'm just going to do that quickly, but I'm pretty sure that will be good. Let me see, put it in straight. And I'm just going to go in the part that it needs to cut, and then I go back out. Did you hear that click? That's about it. Oh no, that didn't work. Reason why is that the cutting is, well, it's still nice. The cutting is on that side. Could have done it differently. So that, then I could just have cut it off. You see the stitching is here. So, and I did not, could have done it this way, but then, wait, I'm going to go in one more time. I'm going to lay it here. And I think that will work, but then you need to be very careful that you only go in. I'm just going to try, because you know, if you don't try, we don't know. So I'm going to put this over slightly, just over that cut line. Make sure this is in the middle. Then the only thing I need to watch very carefully is that I only go in this far and not any further. So you put it in straight. Make sure you put it in straight. You see, and I only want to hear this click. So you go here. Let me show you. I'm going to get my machine here. I'm going to show you. I have long plates in there, which is not handy for this, but I want to show you. So there we go. So I'm going to put it in this way and put it in straight. And I only want to hear this click. So if I go in, let's see if this works. And maybe not, but so wait. Wait for it. Now I feel the pressure. Click and go back. I think that should do it. And of course, I love it when the plants come together. Here you go. That's the way to do it. But don't go any further, because then it starts to kind of trim that, of course. But this works perfectly. Let me see the comments. I don't know. I know. Yeah, it's a versatile set. Yeah. Yes, I wonder how that, if that he's as advised to cut off the top part. Okay. Oh, the top part of that one? Oh, okay. Yeah, I think I like the top part, but you know, you can do that as well. But I kind of like this, like this one, because if you start putting stuff in from the top, if this is shorter, you cannot put anything in there, and now I can. So, but that's of course your own preference. And I missed that part from Esther. I know I looked, because she said, oh, I told her some things, and then I said, well, some things I didn't see, because I was prepping. But you see now here, that's absolutely perfect. You see, because now I have the stitching all around, and so now you probably don't put anything here, but I like to have this at the top, and then I can just put in things there. And you can of course put a label here if you want. You can put a label there, or you know, if you want to close that off, if you want to close this off a little bit, you can put something like that there. Then you have that pocket. Oh, the here, just over the stitch, because I really like the finish of that stitch at the bottom. But different possibilities. So that is that set. We're still in set one. You see, there is so much you can do. This needs to go like this. Okay, so that is that one. Then, of course, you can just take this and put it on a page. So that extra piece, and just stick it here. That's another way you can do. And then you see right away, if you see this, then you see right away that if you kind of line it up here, that it fits perfectly. So that's the way you can use your die there. And let me see. So I showed you this. I showed you this. So that is what I had for this one. So I'm going to put this away. I love it when you can stretch your dies with different things. That's just, I think that's the way to go. Okay, now this one. So I did that one as well. So I did... Oh, I did that. I did not do that with this, but this can be a perfect border on a slimline card as well. You see, that's absolutely perfect. You can also cut it on the side of a little bit smaller piece of cardstock. You see, this will be perfect on a slimline card. I did not try 5x7s or 6x6. I'm pretty sure you can kind of figure that out with other shapes and sizes as well. Okay, what did I all miss? Vanessa, stretching dice for more combination. Awesome. Yeah, Belinda, I love that. Creativity, I know. I try. Okay, Alicia, you know, I was in an hour early because we are an hour ahead of you now. Like, no, we kind of, instead of 8 hours, we have 7 hours difference. So make sure to kind of share everything so your friends will see this as well. So this one, let's start with the slimline card. So 3.5 by 8.5. Look at that. How perfect is that? So this piece is 3.25 by 8.25. 3.25 by 8.25, this piece. And this fits exactly, not almost, but exactly inside the die. You see? That's exactly fits in there. So again, make sure when you cut your piece that you put it inside the lines so that it doesn't cut off a little sliver on the side here, because you don't want that. But how perfect is that? How perfect is that? So that's this one. You see? Slimline card. Love that. And of course, then you can decorate, cut it in a different color, of course. I was just testing things here. Then, hi, Vanessa. Happy to see you here. And Vanessa, for lots and lots more inspiration, of course, for the newbies here, you can go to the Elizabeth Craft Designs Planners and Journaling group. That's especially for this. But of course, Elizabeth Craft Designs, don't forget to check our YouTube channel or subscribe to our YouTube channel, because we post everything there as well. And then also, what do we have? So we have Facebook, Instagram, of course. Instagram. And okay, so this one, an A4 size card. So 5.5, the white is 5.5 by 4.25. I took the die, so this is 5.25 by 4. And then I kind of figured out, kind of looked, I think I was here, about here. You see, I was about here and glued it down, piece of tape, and then it cuts this. And with this one, it's perfect. Because if I would have put it here, you see, I would have cut like half in the, like in one of the fruits. If I would have cut it here, it was half of the fruit. So I kind of figured out, okay, where does that piece fit the best to kind of make it look like it was basically that it was made for it. So that you kind of can see, okay, this is not a planner die. This die was designed to make an A2 size card, or a slimline card, or a larger card, you see. So that is an A2 size card. Then again, a absolute perfect fit for, oh, let me put this set here, you see, because that's that one. A perfect fit for the Sidekick. Absolute perfect fit. I'm going to put this away because I showed that. Here, look at that. I'm going to put it in here again. Look at that. Nobody will know that this was originally designed for the planners. Look at that. Cannot fit any better. And I should have white behind it. Let me get a piece of white behind it so you can see it better instead of blue. Look at that. That's just perfect. Perfect. And so again, what I did, you cut the base page. So you take the base page here. I did paste, you see that? So cut that one. And then you do exactly the same as what I did with the rope. Going to find the space where it works best. And in this case, where I think it looks like I was at the top or not. Yeah, you see, I just lined it up at the top, and that was the perfect fit for this one. You see? So again, stay away from the cut line there, but here, and it ends here. How perfect is that? How perfect is that? I think Esther thought about this. No. And the only thing I had to do with this one, because when you cut, I had a very tiny sliver here, and you just round it off with your scissor. That's the only thing I needed to do with this one. So now, yeah, I know the time. I know the time. Yeah. Yeah. So, tomorrow is my birthday. True. And, and before I forget to say, on Wednesday, because I still have lots of things to do. So Wednesday, Rianne, Rihanna will be here, and on Friday, Marga will be here. So Wednesday, Rihanna, don't miss it, and Friday, Marga, don't miss that one. You see, so perfect page for in your sidekick. Let me, I should have a light page here. Wait, let me see. Do we have a lighter page in here? Yeah, can back this on here. Just going to put it in here for a second. You see how cool that looks? Absolutely love it. So then I think, oh, now I want to start a new sidekick as well. Ta-ta-ta-ta, so many ideas. And then I, so yesterday I had loads of fun making, making like the little beach houses. And then, so I did this one at Creator Craft and we opened the door. That was an idea, I think, from Janice as well. Can you open the door? And it was in my mind, but I didn't do it yet. So I did open the door. And then driving back, I was, you know, I said to Esther, oh, I know what's to put in that door. I'm going to put a penguin there. Because I've been to Phillip Island in Australia. And there the penguins, I think I told it before, but the penguins all are walking on the beach. I post a link on our page in a Facebook group. When you see this house, there's a link to Penguin Island, to Phillip Island, which is super cool. So I thought, oh, they go on the beach, so I give them a little beach house. So you know, and that's of course from the mason jar. So I open the door. I have a little cord here to open the door, which is cool. So lots of ideas with that. And then talking about that one, that will be a fantastic slim line as well. Is this dry? Yeah. So just to show you, all the houses will fit perfectly. So I can see a card like this with all the houses and a lot of penguins in there. You see, so you know, maybe give him a beach chair as well. So lots and lots of ideas with that one. That will be cool as well. And then talking about that little shack here, we came to the idea to make it a garden, but I'm not going to get to that this time because I have one card that I want to show. But making this into a garden shack, then the chairs can be like in wood as well. This can be a wheelbarrow, so this can be all kind of fruits, but it can also be a wheelbarrow standing in front of the shed. And then I thought about all the plants that we have, because we have all those fun plants in the journal collection, in the planner collection. So I thought, oh, a garden shed and then all like little plants in the back will be fabulous as well. So I know I need to do a lot of other things, but oh mighty, my head is spinning. And of course, this is the original page here with the large page there. So that is that one. Then, well, this is not a page, and the other one is not. So I have one more page to show, but I'm just going to show you this as well. So this is the, you see the parts. I love this die set. Wait, let me get the set. I have white magnets because I didn't find any other anymore. Let me get that set with this. So that's this one. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful set. So what I did actually add the whole helmet there. I did this with some embossing powder. So I did some ink and then embossing powder on the tentacles. And I used this one. So I used the fired brick. Distress, is it distress gloss? Do they call it like that? That's embossing. Oh, embossing glaze. Embossing glaze from Ranger. And I did it there. And to get this effect, I used the dabber. So not the pad, but the dabber. With this one, I used the whole pad, the ink pad. But with this one, I only did the dabber. And I heated this one a little bit more, so it gets a little bit darker. Basically, I'm burning it. So you see, so I was burning it a bit, and then I liked that effect in this. This idea you already saw from, I think Esther showed it. I think Anita had it in one of her pages. And the idea with this one is, I don't know if I get to it, otherwise I just do it later and show you. Because the idea with this one is to make a slimline card. Oh, and I have the, I did this, the shells. So I did a shell, like I didn't. So if you die cut it out of gold, I thought it was a waste. So what I basically did is I cut a solid white, stuck the line on this one from this. And then did an inlay from the leftover pieces of gold. And then I need to sand that one, but let me see if I sand that one, because it's, let me see. Okay, you could put some words in the bottom square and pop, you could put some words in the bottom square Oh, we're talking like way back when, correct? About the other page. I'm so behind. Oh, I need to scroll. There's tons of comments there. Thank you. Yeah, I miss everything. Birdhouse. We talked about that as well during the show. Yeah, birdhouse. Thank you, Belinda. So you see, if you send this one, and I'm sending the paper down as well. I don't know if that's the best way to do it. I probably should have sent the gold first. Yeah. Well, it's still pretty because I don't want the shiny gold in here. But so that one, and the idea for this one is to kind of watercolor the background a bit. I did paste, although I did not use watercolor paper. I used soft finish. So I did some stenciling with one of the stencils from Ilse and Charlene. The one with the kind of what, you know, made me think about waves. You see this one. So I used that one. Oh yeah, with Josette's ocean. Oh yeah. Do you know if you have? I was actually, because I had an assignment to do for a creative scrapbooker, and I ended up not doing that. I cannot show you what I created because that's not allowed. But it's cool. And but I was also looking at the beach house, or this one for instance, in the shell. You know the pop-up shell card from Josette's? Do I have that here? No. But you know the pop-up shell, that big one. Anya's thinking, what is she talking about? I don't know how it's called, but you have the big shell. It's a double shell, it's a big shell from your set. I have no idea. Did you find it? Yeah, oh, she did. Anya will put a link in. But that one is cool, and then you can put one of like the beach houses in there. That will be super cool. Oh my goodness, there's so much stuff. But this was the idea for this one. Kind of put this here a little bit, maybe like this. I don't know exactly. Or hook it in there somewhere. And then I thought these two at the bottom here. And then you have a fantastic men's card. So that's a slimline. You can put a saying in here. You know, I can here I can put some clam. Oh, yeah, it's a clamshell. Yeah, but we don't call it that way. But you see, you can put summer holiday there. So that is cool. So lots and lots of ideas with that one. I think that's a great men's card. But if I get the chance, I will do this. I will put this here. But I might just... Oh, there, what do we call it? Oh, oyster shell card. Thank you. I did not even know them. But like, so a lot of this collection will be super cool. And especially this one, I think. If you put that in... I do have the... Oh, give me a second. I'll be right back. Just a second. I'll just get the die. And I will cut a... got it. Oh, that's so nice when I have everything here. And then I have the pop-up piece to go in there. So I got the die. And then I got the pop-up piece. So that is this set. So let me die cut this quickly. Do I have... cardstock here. Of course I have cardstock here. That would be crazy if I not had that. Just a piece of white, I think. That will be fun. Just keep talking and I'll, you know, I should read back. And just give each other ideas because there's so many ideas with this. So I'm just going to run that through. Because some ideas I need to do right away, otherwise I forget them again. I know the adrenaline is pumping. That's exactly what it is. And then I have assignments I need to do, which are actually super fun as well. So it's, you know, it's all good. But sometimes you just want to have no assignments. And then just, you know, keep doing what you want to do. And because all the ideas are in your head. Okay, so that's that. And I just want to put the pop-up piece in. This will be cool as well because, yeah, there's fun elements in there. So I'm just going to put this one in there because, oh, it's going to be on that side because that's the outside. And I'm just going to glue it in there. So basically what you do, you fold this. If you cut the solid penguin in a collar and cut it on the belly and cut the feet off, you have a penguin with swimming pants. I need to read that again. I need to read that one again. Oh my goodness. It's so fun to see all the ideas. And I miss a lot as well. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to put this about in the middle. So the pieces there. going to run it through again, and I should have a clean plate, and I don't have a clean plate, and but you know, it's just to kind of figure out what all fits on there, because it will be fun. So now you have your pop-up piece here, so take that off, and then I have my card. Put this aside, but then you can see right away that you can mix all those pieces in this collection as well. So put this, push this forward, and of course then you need to cover this. Oh no, you know what I did wrong? While I'm saying this, I thought, no, you have this extra piece that you can actually use as a pop-up piece in there as well. And then you cut this pop off in this thing. But you know, I didn't do that, so that's fine. You can also cover this with other paper. But look at that. You see this one, will that fit? No, it will stay. No, it will. Here, if you put it sideways, which can, then you can decorate it, you see. So if I put this here and then close it, that will perfectly fit. So you can put this one on there. So that will be cool. And then of course you would use all the, kind of all the other elements in the back. Or you can put like this one here, you see. Or you can take this one, you see. This one will fit perfectly there. So that will be cool. But also, of course, a big one for that will be that fun beach house. You see this one, you can put that there and then close it. And then you can put another beach house there. So lots and lots of ideas with that one as well. So keep that in mind. Keep that in mind. Okay, so I'm going to put this here. If I get to it, I will do that. Otherwise, I'll do it later. So that's that one. Where are we going then? Oh, so this one. Love this one. I'm going to get the original die because mine are on two ugly magnets. And I do have the die here. I know that. That's this one. So this one is the Irish Shutter add-ons. Of course, you have the Irish Shutter. I just got my Christmas cards out, but this is the original from Esther. So again, that one is too big for your sidekick. But of course, this one will fit in your sidekick. This one, I actually thought, oh, this is super cool. This one will fit in your sidekick. And these two, of course, will fit in your sidekick. You see? Like that. So that all works perfectly. Same on a slimline card. No, it's not available yet. No, we're only shipping to stores right now. So that will come in a bit. Oh, and these are the slimlines I had for kind of for Christmas. So showing you that this one will fit on there, you see. So that will fit on a slim line. This of course will fit on a slim line. And these two will fit on a slim line. And that shows you right away that if you want to make slim line cards with this, and here I added the florals. If you want to make slim line cards, where's my base? Oh, this one, I'm going to turn this, well, I can leave it like that. Here, if you have this one as a slim line, that this will work. If you, this one, you can put three on there. This one, you can put three on there. One, two, yeah, three. And this one, probably two. I think three will be too much for this one. But so you can use all these as well on the slim line. So that is that one. Absolutely beautiful die. With of course, with florals, that will be absolutely gorgeous. Oh, it's coming, Michelle. I hope everything is going on time. It's just, you know, we're still waiting. Then we go to this one. I love this one. So I actually created this during the live. And Esther told you about... Oh, wait, I'm going to get the real die. Because it's still that ugly magnet. Here you go, this one. So that is the photo film slides. This one, I made a little pocket. You can close it completely. You can put a picture in here. That's what Esther did with her samples here. You see, she had the she has the photos in there. So I made this one. I think I used the book too. I call it a little girl because you know this one has matching stamps. There you go. So that's this one. Absolutely love that. So I did. So basically what I did for Create and Craft as well, kind of go over all the pieces and possibilities, and then as we go, I know Rianne will work with this on Wednesday, and then Marga will probably work with it on Friday as well. Yeah, so this one, I did stamp that little window there, that one, you see. So, and I did stamp the girls. I did stamp all the kind of, you know, I did started stamping on the labels as well. So lots and lots of possibilities. Love that one. And needless to say that this will fit perfectly in your Sidekick as well. Let me find an empty page. Here we go. You see, this is absolutely perfect for your Sidekick. So again, no need for the large planner for this one. You can easily fit it on there as well. And I absolutely love that one. Okay, so that is that one. Then the last but not least is the one with the circles. So that is, where do I have that one? Not that one. Oh, this one. This one. So that is the Planner Essentials 48, the porthole page. Porthole page. And what did I do with that? What did I do with that? Oh yeah, okay. There we go. There we go. I have all those pieces. So I had so much fun just kind of figuring stuff out. First of all, it is absolutely perfect for an A2 size card. Let me get an A2 size card here. So again, I have the 4.25 by 5.5 there. So this one. And you can fit, look at that. And I was thinking, because so this is actually a full 4.25 by 5.5, because then it fits perfectly. If you make this 4 by 5.25, it doesn't fit. Of course, you can trim off a little bit here, but this is actually super cool as well. So you just back that. And then you can imagine here, we start building again. Look at that, you see, you can put the, wait, I actually have the, and you can make a little hinge here on the side or trim off a little bit there. That's all up to you. But let me see. Yeah, the nuts and bolts are absolutely fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. I have so many pieces here. So, of course, the reinforcements. You can put summer in here. Let me see. Fits it. Yeah, that fits as well. You see, that will be nice. And then you have, of course, the portholes. You can make 2 shakers here. Oh, Belinda, you are not feeling better. Oh, Belinda. Oh, I hope you feel better soon. So you can do 2 shakers here. You see, so I did not. Here I put the nuts and bolts on, but you can imagine this will be cool with 2 shakers. And then have this on there. Look at that. Oh, love it. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. You have the little anchor there. And, you know, there's so much you can do. And then, of course, you could, again, you can put those. Oh, if the new wax set will work well with those circles. Yeah, probably. You can put here, you can put those here. And then you have, again, a fantastic card for men. You can make a shaker with the fish in there, what Esther did in one of her pages. So that will be fun. You can put sea stars in there if you want to make a more simple card as well. So lots and lots. I love that. So that's an A2 size card. And for the people that missed it, these are the bolts and nuts, the bolts and the bolts and the screws here. Absolutely fabulous. To watch this today, since not able to craft, should be better soon. Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Okay, so that's that one. And then, so with this one, basically, I took the 5.5 by 4.25 because here you see that this lines up exactly onto. On 2 portholes. You see, again, not on a cut line there. And then you have a perfect one for an A2 size card. And then the next one, of course, is the slim line. Couldn't be any better. So this one. You see how many ideas? It's too much. It's too much. Oh, the wax, foundry wax to use it. Yeah, I know. So this one, but of course, yeah, I have wax as well. So, 8.5 by 3.25. This piece, 8.25 by 3.25. The craft. Put it on here. And look at that again. You see, perfect fit. Perfect fit. Could not find you on Korean Craft. Oh, Jessica, I was there yesterday. I think you can watch back. I think that's what, but I don't know if it worked, if it works already. But I'm basically showing you everything here as well. Because I don't think you can buy the product there anymore, because that's done. That's only there, I think, when it's available. But you see this one, and then when you start building up this one. Oh, it might even be more fun. And you see, oh, let's do this one here. But I would do different cardstock. But again, here I go with my, you know, you can use this on there as well, like just one. But if you want to use here, and then, oh, how cool will that be? And then I would need a shaker somewhere. I only have two of the circles. Do I have three? Oh, I love that. You see, put acetate in there, put some shaker. There must be, I know we made little bags of gel as well at one point. What do we use for the gel? Like that this is water. We did that. Is it just hair gel that we used? Here you see, that one. Isn't that fabulous? Love that, love that. And I did look into, but I didn't get to it anymore, if this would be, if I would be able, let me check. I'm going to leave this as is. Can I find a way to just make circles? If I use the die, because this of course embossed. You could trim it, but can I, that was the other idea I had. Can I put it in here? I think I can. Wait for it. I don't know if it's going to be perfect, but I'm going to try. Because we're here to try today. So I'm going to put this on here. Make it, but then I need to make this shorter first. Because otherwise it will not go. So I'm going to trim a little bit off of this. And then I can go through my regular machine. If you have an A4, of course, it will always work. But can I use this like this? So I need to make sure I feel the grip again so that it grips. Yeah, I always use the blue hair gel for water in my cards. And what do you use then? Do you use a little Ziploc or something to close it? Is that what we did? I don't know anymore. It's been a while. Okay, so make sure this grips here. Does it grip there? I don't know if it... I think it does. I think it grips, but I don't know for sure. I'm just going to glue this down for a second. And I can look from the other side, of course. Yeah, I'm going to look from the other side. What I'm going to do, oh, I can just put tape here. And then a longer piece of tape there. With a treasure chest. Oh, the treasure chest from Josette. That will be cool. That will be cool. I can get that. Because I know where that one is. So I need to kind of make this grip in those inner circles, I think. Where do I... Oh, I need to do it on... Oh, you know what the difficulty is with this one? Yeah, you need to grip on the inner circles. Because here it cuts, but it doesn't have a cut line yet. And here it's embossed. So that will not work. I don't know if that's going to work, but I'm going to try. So you need to grip on the inner circles, which I have right now. Then I tape this down. And it could be go totally wrong, but I just want to try. Do I get... Just going to run it through. And then I will get the treasure chest, because that will be cool. Yeah, so the whole Under the Sea collection. Oh, the mermaid. If you have the mermaid going through the portholes, that will be fun. I don't know if this is working, but I just want to try. Let's see. I'm just going to do this. It might be. Let's see. Oh, there we go. There we go. I think that's pretty perfect. No, not. No, it's not. It's actually not. No, let's be honest, it's not. Because here I'm off, you see? Yeah, so don't do that. I don't think that's a good tip. I think the tip is to use it like this. Because this one is, it didn't cut completely. And maybe it works in a, if I take more time. But right now it's not. Oh, but then, of course, if we do this, and then add these, will it cover completely? No, yeah, well, you know, close, no, but then I can just use three of these. No, that's not a tip that I would do. I would use this one. I would use this tip. And then if you cut it in like a nice blue paper and then put the whole porthole thing on there. So forget about this one. Maybe if you try better. So, okay, so I'm going to put some stuff here. You see, I'm just going to kind of have you look at this. While I run over to the box with the design from Josette. I have that here in 1 second. If you see the mess here, you would not think how it's, you would think, how is it possible that she knows where everything is? Well, this I actually know, because I did bring all my samples to the studio. So I have everything here. So I have my whole collection, you see, organized under the sea. Oh, so proud of myself. No, it's actually, okay, so let's see if we're going to do this. That will be super fun, by the way. That will, so like a little shaker in there as well. Okay. And I need all the like all the stuff going on there. Oh, the lighthouse we have. Yeah, the lighthouse we have. Yeah, the whole Under the Sea collection from Yozette will be fabulous with this one. Okay, let me see if I have some loose parts here. Otherwise, I need to kind of get, well, everything will work well, of course, with this one. Let me see if I have some loose pieces here. But it will be so, like the crab. Can you see the crab going through everything? Oh, let me find some things. Wait for it. I'm just trying to see if I have stuff that I can easily take apart, because that's what I do then. But there is not, I don't have loose mermaids or something. But here, this one, I'm going to take this because I know I made this card several times. So that's Mia. I'm going to just take this apart. Sometimes I do that. Kind of trying to see, but that will be really fun. Is this glued here? It is. That's loose, so this one I can easily take off. There we go. Anita knows what I'm doing, because I do that a lot with cards. Here, you see, so take that away. But that's, here you go. That will be fantastic. Put it at the bottom, and then with the seaweed and the, whose idea was that? Thank you. That's why we do the lives, because we get inspired by everybody. And then, so of course we have the, like, Yozette's octopus here, which is the more kind of cute one. So you can put that in there as well with the portholes. But of course, if you want to go more like piratey, is it more a pirate? Look at that. Kind of have him here. That's just perfect here on an A2 size card. But then I need that gel in there. I need some water. Okay, I hope I inspire you, and that I see this back on our own page. It would be great. Here, so you put that there. Have some water going. And then this one here. That will be so cool. Oh, fantastic. Fantastic. Love it, love it, love it. Love it. And then of course the let me see if I have a because sometimes, but you can see the whole combination of that. I'm not going to show you if I'm going to rip up a card apart. No, I cannot do that one. It's so nice. You see this one, it was from Anita, but you can see that mermaid in there. So cool. No, you know, it's such a way. I have such beautiful cards. I cannot take those apart. Can I take this off easily? Yeah, I can take this one off easily. Wait, I'm just taking one of your Z's cards. Here, this one. I can take the mermaid off here easily. So I'm going to do that. Oh, I ripped her tail off, but I can add that again. You see, I need to put her little tail back. But then that one going through the porthole. And I know a lot of you have this collection. So get that out as well. That will be fun. I know the clam card is really cool. Yeah. But now, of course, combining everything. You see, I didn't get to that yet. So I'm definitely not going to make a card today, because that is not. I will just finish it during the week and show you. So put her tail back on. I am the master of reusing, because I don't always have time to do things that I need to do. But you can see her. Look at that. Ah, that will be so cool on a card as well. Look at that. Her behind that. That will be so cool. And then you can do another one here. And then, yeah, too many ideas. Yeah, thank you, Belinda. I try to. Because I honestly try to. Because I think that's the, you know, that's what you want to do. I don't want you to buy stuff, use it, put it away, next collection, put it away. I like you to get everything out. But you can see lots and lots of ideas with that one. So I think I'm going to leave it at this for today. Because there's too many ideas. The summer kit, oh yeah. And then if you put gel in there, and then if you cut these and then behind the, so if you put if you make a shaker gel and then put this behind it, we never did, you know, it's been a while since I've seen gel used for a shaker. We all have those shiny stuff, but if you put this behind it, so acetate behind this, so make this into a separate shaker, acetate, gel in there, and then have the seaweed there, and then, you know, you have everything going on. That will be super cool as well. Okay, it is 5 minutes before one. So I think that's it for today, because this was, oh, and I cut, like I did all these, like all the stems and that kind of stuff. So there's so many fun things to do with this collection, but now also combine it, because we have a sea turtle in this one. It's here, this is also from your set. Look at that. It was also so cool. And then, so if you have this one, here, look at that. And then just put the treasure chest there and here, and then this one behind there. That will be so cool as well. And then work with the tentacles on that part. That will be super cool. That will be super cool. Okay. Let's turn the camera around. And yeah, there we are. And then I want to thank you for watching, of course. Like this was, I really like this life. It's really tiring as well, because now I want to do all those things that are here. And that sometimes is tiring. But it's also so much fun. And it's so much fun to see all the ideas from all of you. And I know I will see, you know, creations from the ideas from this live on our Elizabeth Crafts Designs family page, or on the Elizabeth Craft Designs ECD planners and journaling. And of course, if you put them on Instagram, do hashtag Elizabeth Craft Designs, hashtag ECD, so that it all comes to our page as well. Do I say that correct, Anya? If the, yeah, I do. Yeah, because I'm so not good at Instagram. But so that it all shows up. So it was great. I loved it. So thank you all for watching. And again, Wednesday, Rihanna will be here. And Friday, Marga will be here. And you see me again next Monday. Bye-bye.